I'm here at CES in Las Vegas, one of the world's biggest technology shows, where hundreds of thousands of people have come to see the latest advancements in electric vehicles, AI, and even cars that can change different forms. Kia presented one of the biggest and most ambitious visions of any brand at CES. So they have their platform beyond vehicles, as they're calling them, which are totally modular. So the outside frame could be changed from a personal commuter car to a delivery van to a pickup truck in the same day. And then even inside, they have a rail system where you can kind of mix and match seats and different components. Here they have a cabinetry system they also debuted that is being used as a closet. Up front, that could be a home office. The steering wheel, it flips up and then now it's a lamp and it's illuminating the dash, which has turned into a desk space. So they really want consumers and businesses to be using vehicles for multiple purposes. It's more sustainable and it's just, they think the future of smart connected cities. And it's also really happening. So they have built a factory, they've already started working on these. They're gonna start with business customers. I would say in maybe 10 years, 20 years, a long range time, you could have one of these vehicles yourself. Honda had one of the biggest EV announcements of the show. This is a concept vehicle for their new Zero CVs line of EVs that are coming in 2026. There are two of them. This one's more of a sedan kind of style, and something inspired by this is gonna hit dealers in 2026. The other one is kind of a new class of vehicle. It's not a minivan, it's not an SUV, but it's called the Space Hub. It has kind of a living room style interior where you can hang out, eventually kind of have that autonomous driving experience where you're just using it as a workspace or a time to chat. So what they're really focusing on here is the battery technology. So they're going to have thin batteries at the base that are lightweight, and they're saying will have less degradation, so about 10% degradation instead of 20% after 10 years of driving. And the big stat is that they'll be able to charge from 10 to 15 minutes. So that's not coming in 2026, but it will evolve over the next couple of years, and it'll be super fast charging, lightweight EVs, and Honda's saying all the right things, so we just have to see if it happens. Mercedes had a lot of exciting announcements about AI this year at the show. The first is that they're adding an AI assistant inside the car so you can have better conversations with it, and it will also do things like learn your preferences, when you want the air conditioning turned on, when you want to listen to the news. It's just going to be constantly learning and interacting with you. This is also very exciting. This car is going to have level 3 self-driving technology, which will be the most self-driving on the roads in the US. So it only has clearance in California and Nevada. It's not on the road yet. And really interesting approach, they're gonna light up these headlights in turquoise when it's in self-driving mode, so you as a driver can actually see if a car around you is driving itself. Mercedes has a lot going on with EVs. They already offer several of them, but here at the show, they have a new one here. It's the first time it's been in the US. It debuted a couple months ago. It's called the Concept CLA class, and this is gonna be their entry-level EV that's gonna compete with the Tesla Model 3. We don't know exactly what the range is gonna be or the price, but they've been very open that this is their entry-level model. And if it does compete with Tesla, it's going to be a lot nicer on the inside. You can see it has super interesting seats. It has a dash that extends from wall to wall. Definitely one to watch. I'm sitting in the Pebble Flow electric RV. So this is one of the ways that electrification technology is not only being used in cars, but it's also really improving other types of vehicles. So this is a pull-behind trailer, and it has a self-propelling system, so it helps the vehicle in front not lose as much range or as much gas if it's a gas car. It's made by former employees of Apple and Tesla and Volvo. Very modern, really open inside, beautiful kitchen with all the amenities. It actually has a stove you can take out and use outside to camp. The bathroom, when you touch the glass, it fogs up and becomes cloudy because, of course, it's a tight space, so you're gonna need that. So this will be on the market in late 2024, and it is eligible for a small tax credit. It's not cheap. It starts at $109,000 or $125,000. And what you get for the extra price on the $125,000 is actually autonomous features. So this is going to be the first electric RV that can kind of help you set up. It can automatically hitch itself to the trailer of the vehicle in front. Super cool. This is a brand new category. I'm really excited about this and just kind of seeing electrification in a different way. This is a Vietnamese EV brand with a really interesting story. It's called VinFast. They're brand new, so you probably want to look at that logo. You might see it on the streets in a couple years, or even today, because there are already VinFast vehicles in the US. So Vietnam does not have a huge automotive tradition. We don't see Vietnamese EVs on the road like we see Japanese or Korean or some other Asian countries. So this is a really big national push from Vietnam. Does have a female CEO, which I love, but they're serious. They've already broken ground on a factory to make these cars in North Carolina. They debuted this pickup at CES. This is their first full pickup truck. They also have a compact car called the VF3. This is an example of a brand new EV brand we're seeing at CES. Not established. They're really trying to break into the US market, and I think you're gonna wanna look out for them.